Chapter 12. Failed Exams. The next morning, Princess Celestia entered the classroom to begin her lessons for the day, but there was no pony there. Her mind felt hazy, and she wondered for a moment if she was still dreaming. She touched her hoof to her face and felt the coolness of her hoof cuff against her cheek. It was definitely morning, and this was all happening for real. Perhaps the students were running late. She took a seat at the desk in front of the room to wait for them and gather her thoughts. Princess Luna had visited her last night. Princess Celestia didn't usually like when Luna appeared in her dreams, as it felt invasive for some pony so close to her to be able to explore her subconscious mind. But the dream she'd had this time was productive. She had always suspected that there was something off about the time glass, and now she understood why. Soon, Duchess Diamond Waves would as well.
"Try it again!"
Princess Celestia heard a faint voice say. She stood up and followed the sound, which grew louder as she approached the main hall.
"Every pony, let's focus a little more, okay?"
It was the voice of Duchess Diamond Waves. Her blue mane and yellow hide shone brightly across the dark hall. She was pacing back and forth in front of the students, who were all lined up in a perfect row against the wall facing her. In the middle of the room was a large tub of water. Ambrosia Breeze stood next to it, looking down at the ground. She seemed dejected.
"Come on, Ambrosia Breeze,"
Diamond Waves encouraged.
"Everybody says they saw you do it. I just really want to see it too."
The Duchess held up a clipboard and a quill and stared down at the young filly.
"As soon as you show me the water bubble enchantment, you'll be done."
Ambrosia shifted back and forth from hoof to hoof. She looked to her classmates and bit her magenta-colored lip.
I can't.
"Look, students, I didn't want to scare you, but I think you should know that
I'm leaving soon,"
Princess Celestia interrupted, trotting into the room.
"And I shall have to say goodbye."
"You will?"
Rainy Air whimpered.
"Princess Celestia, please don't go,"
cried Sandy Shore.
"But what about the party on the beach we were planning?"
Flora squeaked, flipping her teal mane away from her sad, sweet lavender face.
"I already made hats."
The tension was palpable, but Princess Celestia looked up to her friend's face.
"What do you say, Di?"
Diamond Waves looked like she couldn't hold on to her stress any longer. She threw her hooves up in surrender.
"Fine, students! Go and have your party on the beach with Princess Celestia."
Diamond Waves used her magic to clean up the basin of water.
"We weren't making any progress anyway. It's no use."
"Wow, thank you, Headmistress,"
the students lit up.
"So cool."
They cantered back to their rooms to get their beach items, all except Flora, who was only retrieving her elaborate hoof-made party hats.
"Sure,"
Diamond Waves replied, cracking a fake smile.
"Have fun."
She took a look around the empty room. It looked even bigger with all the furniture pushed to the sides like it had been for the test. The Duchess sighed, her face showing signs of defeat. She'd lost hope.
"Are you coming?"
Princess Celestia asked. She used her magic to set all the tables and chairs straight with one jolt.
"Down to the beach?"
"No." Diamond Wave shook her head, overcome with emotion.
"I have to go to my quarters and reread the prophecy. Maybe there's a clue I'm missing that could predict when exactly the attack is going to happen. Then I'll know how to prepare."
Celestia trotted over to her friend and hugged her.
"Relax and come with me. This will be over soon."
"How do you know that?"
Diamond Waves asked.
"Have you seen the time glass today?"
Celestia raised her brows in mock horror.
The sands have near run out, Diamond. It's time to meet your destiny. Hurry up. It's waiting.